Here's the Beatles, You're Gonna Lose That Girl. It's in E, it's got some kind of strange chords in it. So straight E, C minor, C sharp minor 7, you're gonna go to the 4th fret. You can play a D there, a D shape at 4-5-4, but don't play anything lower than that, just play the top three strings. Or you can bar across the 4th fret and play D6, G4, B5, and E4. So 6-4-5-4. It's like a C chord that you're barring at the 4th fret. Okay, C sharp minor 7. F sharp minor 7, you can play an F sharp minor. You can play F sharp minor 7 this way with your ring finger on A at 4, or you can add your B at 5. So any of those will work. Let's see what else is in this thing. B7, we know that one up here, or this. Okay. And that's the strange chords. So it's kind of a neat song. In fact, I really like it. So let's have the Beatles play it, and I'll show you the lead afterward, okay? The little fill that George plays in the middle. All right, here we go. You're gonna lose that girl. There you go, the Beatles. Now here's the little lead part, the little fill that George puts in there. The chords are. Just the same as the, what is that part? Like the main verse, E, G7, G sharp 7, F sharp minor 7, and B7. So those are the chords. Here's the fill. So you're playing B and E, a little bit one on G. So you're playing B at 8, and you're gonna bend that to 7. You do that 4 times. So you're on B8 and you're going to bend it, and then you're going to play E7. So, and then you just play the B8 one time. Then you're going to bend it again and go down to the 9th on the G. And then you're going to play the 12th on E. And then you're going to go to the 14th on B, bend it and release it, and end up on 12 at 2. 12 2 times. So here's the whole thing real slow. One more time. So pretty cool. All right, that's the Beatles, and you're going to lose that girl.